Sad. Chris Stevens, Glenn Doherty, Sean Smith, Tyrone Woods. Two of their families have called us and said, please don't take us down this path again.
Well, you know, I'd like to believe Nancy Pelosi, but why would they call Nancy Pelosi when she doesn't have the power? Wouldn't they call John Boehner and say, don't take us down this path again? You know, you never know what you hear from the Democratic leadership, whether it's Harry Reid saying, well, Koch brothers or Mitt Romney never paid a dime of income tax in 10 years. I mean, you know, you got to take it with a grain of salt. Joining us now, as promised, is David Bozell, executive director of For America, of course, son of our friend Brent Bozell, the president of the media and founder of the Media Research Center. Hello, David.
Good. How you doing? Thanks for having me, Steve.
I'm doing well. No, good. I know you're not on specifically to talk about this, but this is just, you know, well, I mean, it's like John Boehner then should come back and play the videos of the mother of one of the dead heroes and the father of another blaming Hillary and saying they want answers. I mean, what does that accomplish, what she just said?
It's the first time I heard that bite. It's stunning, Steve. It really is. I mean, four Americans died. There has yet to be a single interview of anyone who was there. There doesn't seem to be any desire on the part of the administration to get to the bottom of it. And the thing is, Steve, is you know, Americans are such a forgiving people. We send our fathers, our sons, our wives, our sisters, our brothers, our nieces, our nephews to these far off places. To defend our freedoms, to give us the opportunity to do what we're doing here, conversing over the internet. And in return, the deal is that in return, our elected officials are supposed to just be open and honest and transparent about what happens in these places. And throughout the entire Benghazi saga, there's not been a single solitary soul within this administration that has done that. They have just stonewalled, lied in a number of different cases. You can see the steam coming out of Daryl Issa's ear with these oversight committee hearings, because he's not getting anywhere in this investigation because he's being stonewalled every single time. So, it's really classic Clintonian politics. Get all the bad news out of the way and then just ask the country and ask the press, you know, why are we talking about this? Let's move on. Hence why the organization MoveOn.org got started, because of that tagline during the Lewinsky saga. Let's move on, move on.
Right, right.
And everyone's been pointing to her candidacy in 2016, but I do not think she's going to be able to live this one down.
Well, yeah, there's that, and there's several others. And, you know, let's go over to the other scandal, and that's the IRS scandal and Lois Lerner. John Boehner said over the weekend that he will not throw Lois Lerner in jail, even though it's within his power to do so, and even though the House voted to hold her in contempt of Congress. Right. He said it's up to Justice Department and Eric Holder to do something now that they've referred it to them. But of course, Eric Holder has been held in contempt of Congress as well. I don't know. I mean, there are those who are saying that she should get immunity. There are those who are saying that her Fifth Amendment rights are being violated. Give me your take on, let's start with the Fifth Amendment. Are you one of those who believes that she gave those rights away when she made an opening statement and denied any wrongdoing and then said she takes the Fifth?
Oh, I don't know about, you know, the legalese and those types of things. I mean, it sure sounds like she did waive her Fifth Amendment rights by speaking initially. It sure sounds like she did. She seems willing to go to jail for this administration, Steve. She really does. And the email traffic that's been discovered by ISIS committee already have tied her targeting of conservatives to the Federal Election Commission. They've tied her to the Justice Department, which now holds the fate in their hands, or holds her fate in their hands. But she seems altogether all too willing to go to jail. I mean, her emails say to her cohorts in crime that they're going to get creamed for this. And then they should. Gosh, Boehner is so bloody frustrating, though. He just comes out over the weekend because he hasn't done a Sunday talk show in a quarter. So this is basically his PR strategy, is to do one Sunday talk show per quarter, and he seems to think that that's enough. And he just goes off and says that they're not going to be doing any prosecuting at all of Lois Lerner, that yes, you know, she targeted tens of thousands of self-identified Tea Partiers and self-identified conservatives and with audits and threatening them in every which way imaginable. But the Republican Party and the upper echelons of the GOP leadership just seem altogether content with continuing to fund every single budget expenditure that they need to do these types of things. I mean, if the GOP was serious, they'd go to the steps of Capitol Hill and say, enough already. Unless and until we get to the bottom of this investigation,
no more appropriations for the IRS.
Done. Yeah. You'd have these bureaucracies snap to it in a second, yeah. if they were afraid of losing their expenditures and losing their funds. But they are on total. The GOP in the House leadership I'm talking about specifically, is in total prevent defense mode, which was what their strategy was in 2012. When they thought that they would reclaim everything.
Well, David, do you think that they should, first of all, give her immunity? I mean, I guess they want to find out what she wants immunity from, like behind closed doors. If her lawyer was serious, his lawyer wanted to address the Congress before they voted on holding her in contempt. That didn't happen. Right. I mean, all the lawyer's got to do is call up ISA and say, look, let's have a meeting, you and I, at a coffee shop, and here's what she knows. Give her immunity. But they're not even going that route, the Lerner people.
Well, gosh, if they had something to offer, which I think ISA believes that she does, the email traffic suggests coordination between various agencies.
But you put your finger on it, David. I don't think she fears anything. I don't think she fears she'll ever go to jail. Her Holder's not going to prosecute this.
Right. Exactly. So it is incumbent upon the checks and balances of this government, which is Congress, our elected. I mean, unless and until the Republican Party is going to get serious about reasserting its constitutionally mandated authority over the rules and regulation-making process in this country, and listen until they get serious about this stuff, we are simply not free people. We cannot go kick down IRS's door or kick down the EPA's door or the FEC's door. We rely on our elected officials to be those checks and balances, to take our tax dollars and spend them wisely and refrain from spending them if they don't think they're going to be spent wisely. That's kind of the simple arrangement that we have in this country. And the GOP just blank check, blank check, blank check. They have the power of the purse. I know that gets thrown around there fairly loosely, but that's what the founding fathers designed our system to be.
All right, David, let me ask you, we got about 2 minutes left. Immigration reform. Marco Rubio addressed it on ABC yesterday and said, look, it's simply not a priority of the American people right now. Said, on both sides, he said, one, we're not going to deport 12 million people who are here illegally. And number two, we're not going to give them blanket amnesty. I mean, for some reason, and I know it's the pressure from the commerce people with the money and businesses, they want this done. And I think the Republican leadership, unfortunately, is planning something.
All I got to do, I don't know if there's a conspiracy, Steve. I kind of believe Boehner when he says that there isn't one. But you're right. I mean, there are a number of people within the establishment who believe that if we just gave everyone amnesty, then they would turn out to vote for us, which is just preposterous.
Yeah, the Republicans are going to gain votes if amnesty is given. Right.
There's a Gallup poll in January. I know it's a little couple months off, but there was a Gallup poll in January. They do this every year. They ask the American people to rank their priorities. Immigration, what came at 3%.
David, in 2012, when Hispanics came out of the polls, out of the polling booth, they asked them, and it was like 4 or 5 on their list, on Hispanics' list.
Exactly,
so the whole thing is a fallacy.
It's Washington consultants just living in this Washington bubble.
Yep.
See,
yep. Absolutely. Hey, David, always great to talk to you. To give us the website and all that for America.
ForAmerica.org. The real fun is on Facebook, facebook.com/ForAmerica. We've got 5.2 million fans, so come join us.
Great. Sounds good. David, thank you very much. Guys. Always appreciate it. David Bozell, ladies and gentlemen, here on the Steve Malzberg Show. Lots to be settled. And when Nancy Pelosi says, you know, she's heard from two of the families saying, don't take us down that road, I think the families are savvy enough to know that Nancy Pelosi has no pull. Why would they call her? Just asking. Just saying. Steve Malzberg Show on Newsmax Television.